A national election this month. Now, Japan's Liberal Democratic Party, the LDP, has pledged to double the country's defense expenditure to measure up against the Chinese threats on the disputed East China Sea. This is the first time any political party in the post-imperial Japan has underlined prioritizing the country's defense by doubling its military spend. Now, a Reuters analysis notes that Japan is not expected to double military spending anytime soon, but Prime Minister Fumio Kishida's Liberal Democratic Party could, over time, abandon the Pacific nations' commitment to this. Now, to keep a military budget within 1% GDP, the United States has been pushing key allies to spend more on defense and increase 2% of the GDP would put Japan in line with the pledges by NATO members as well. Now, in 1945, in the wake of its humbling defeat at the hands of Allied forces during World War II, a former imperialist-led Japan had then made a commitment to abandon its military capability under a surrender agreement presented by the United States. But in 1954, as U.S. forces stationed in Japan went off to fight the Korean War, the nation's need to protect its own domestic territory grew stronger. Japan was then, under a treaty, permitted to maintain a minor reserve of police force, which was later expanded and specialized to cover domestic threats from land, air, or the sea. In the present day, conservative-leaning members of the LDP have time and again expressed their desire to give up the treaty, whereas moderates and liberals within the party have held the tenets of the surrender treaty as a red line. Fearing a return to the same kind of militarism that led the country into World War II, analysts have also noted that public sentiment in Japan has now shifted from concerns about rearming to growing alarm over China's military assertiveness in Asia, particularly towards Taiwan. In a survey of 1,696 people conducted by the Nikkei Business Daily at the end of last year, 86% of the respondents said China posed a threat to Japan, more than 82% who expressed concern about the nuclear-armed North Korea. According to this analysis, Japan's military strategy is focused on defending territory along the edge of the East China Sea, where Tokyo is locked in a dispute with Beijing over a group of uninhabited islands. You know, as these are called Senkaku Islands by Japan or Daiwa Islands by China. Also, military planners say that the first island chain, consisting of Okinawa, chain Taiwan and the island stretching down through the Philippines, from a natural barrier to Chinese operations in the Western Pacific. With an additional $50 billion a year, Japan could buy more equipment now, as well as boost the manufacturing of domestically made equipment, all of which could prove essential in adequately gearing up the country to fight a protracted war. And for more on this, Phoebe is still with us from Tokyo. Phoebe, thank you so much for staying with us. Japan is now rearming itself. Like I just mentioned, the ruling party has vowed to double Japan's defense budget to about $100 billion. What is the strategy behind this decision?
Yes, certainly there is a huge focus on regional defense, as you just reported there. And it's been a very contentious issue since Japan in the Second World War, the post-war constitution. Japan has shied away from military activity. But this has caused tensions over the years, particularly among conservative and right-wing members in the party, really wanting to establish Japan's military far more strongly. So they're looking for, with this increased spending, to try and acquire missiles with up to 1,000 kilometers in striking capacity, also stealth fighters and drones and other weapons. But there's also a focus on cybersecurity, space, and also electromagnetic warfare. So it's really, really a broad base here. Now, why is this being pushed now? Of course, yes, China has been showing increasing military activity, and this has also had a knock-on effect on public sentiment. In polls, people have increasingly said that they are concerned. So that gives the LDP a bit more maneuvering room for implementing these kinds of policies. However, it's going to be quite a test for Prime Minister Kishida. He is known to be fairly moderate, and as I mentioned earlier, he's stressed the need to maintain dialogue with China to keep the doors open and has described China as an incredibly important partner for Japan, particularly when it comes to trade. However, within his cabinet, and assuming the LDP goes on to win the general election at the end of this month, there are many allies of former Prime Minister Abe and also a very powerful figure, Taro Aso, who are known to be on the more conservative right-wing side and have been pushing for this kind of military activity. So this will be a real test as to how much Kishida can stick to a more kind of moderate line versus members of the party pulling Japan in a more military direction. However, there is also the concern over Japan's debt. It's been massively increasing and is still spiraling. And then there's also the pandemic hit economy. The IMF downgraded Japan's economic outlook growth for this year. However, it does look like Japan will be back on growth next year. There's still a lot of uncertain factors here. And that will also play into consideration as to how quickly Japan moves towards implementing this very large defense budget.
All right, Phoebe, thank you so much for joining us with all the latest on that. VEON is now available in your country. Download the app now. Get all the news on the move.